Hey guys, what is going on? Stargazer 1331 back once again, bringing you the 1760s. Man, as luck would have it, I actually rolled off camera, I rolled the dice off camera. So we can just jump into the sucker right away. And without further ado, random book about over 1760. That'll be a 3v3 match. Oh yeah. Let's see. And oh, we got Doomguy's Kirby. Oh yes. Very curious to see what Kirby's partners will. Oh my goodness, Porygon Z. Now I'm even more curious to see what his partners will be. Alright. Alright, Kirby's with Momo and Julie. Super Eight is with freaking the AI patch Hashi. And yeah, then Porygon Z. Wow, that's a toughie. That's a tough call, man. I'm gonna have to give the edge to Porygon Z's team. Because Hashi, like, this is freaking nuts. And Super Eight is no slouch, as we already know. Then again, this is Momo we're talking about here. I don't know what mobile this is, though. If this is, like, the mobile that can just, like, really, like, F up everybody's shit, or what have you. Alright, let's try that again. Round two. Can Momo do better again? Only time will tell. Oh my god, that's so mean. That is so mean. It doesn't do a whole lot of damage, but it can catch, like, I think it's, yeah, it's technically, I think, like, a full screen. That's it, wow. Hit by Psychic. Oh my god, wow, that was over as quick as a flash, good god. Alright, anyway. Random Booger Battle over 1761. Alright, let's do another triples battle. Why not? Hold on. Alright, welcome back, another Roy Squad Ross character. That's Atari Dragon, for those that don't know. Master Hand. Oh boy, who's he with? He's with Mei and Infinite's Broly. And the other team is freaking Goku, AVGN, Angry Video Game Nerd, and an Atari Dragon. Oh man. Oh, I really want Atari Dragon's team to win, although man, I don't know if it's gonna happen. It's funny because a lot of Atari Dragon's attacks are full screen, which is like freaking murder on Master Hand. Yeah, Master Hand's already dead. It's what I'm telling you, man. I think this might be the older Atari Dragon, so he's even more aggressive. Actually, no, I mean, he's just kind of tall, though, so no, I think this is a newer one. Time to start dropping some F-bombs. Oh man, I can't skip the Frankenstein thing. Well, shit. Yeah, I noticed that power-up sound just kept on going. Yeah, like, these kind of attacks are like murder against Master Hand because he can't block any of that. Like, every single one of those sets, he's pretty much boned. That's it. Wow, man. Friggin' taken out easily. Man, the team that I thought would lose ended up winning. Friggin' Angry Video Game Nerd, Goku, and Atari Dragon. Alright. Still won't let me skip it. Right, we get a Frankenstein. You're literally right up in front of the screen. Oh my god, friggin' Big Rig's reference. You are a fucking winner. Oh man, there you go. Alright. So, alright, let's get that random book about number 1762. Let's see, what we got. Alright, let's climb it on up to a 4v4 battle, huh? Let's do it. Yay, the original Cloud Strife, the really, really old. God, this character is getting kind of old now. I mean, I think it might have been one of the first, like, I think it was the first really good version of Cloud Strife to come out for Mugen. Oh my god, we got Ella in this one. And Kula, and Cream, and Kariha, and Neo-Blood Goki, and Shigen, and Chen. Wow, that was fast, Kariha. Like, seriously, wow, that was fast. Sweet Jesus, they're freaking murdering them. That's it, man, over in a flash. Sticking Chen Cloud, Ella, and Kula. Ah, again. Pardon, if I make mistake, it's because I'm very tired right now. Man, that actually finished off Goki. Oh my god. Man, oh my god. Okay, it's literally 4-on-1 Shigen. Or no, 4-on-2, excuse me. Accept your defeat like a man! Wait, actually, because I forgot. Is Cream on the other team? I think. Oh, actually, yeah, Cream is on the other team. Oh, man, nice job, Kula. Oh no, Ella's down. It's all off the Chen and Kula now. Oh man, okay. That was a better round two at least. All came down just to Chen and Kula Diamond on that one, but yeah, that wasn't too shabby. I mean, definitely a better round two. But there you go. There's another one to add to the books as Ella's team gets a nice win there. 2-0. I believe. Yeah, it was 2-0. Okay. Alright. Random Boogie Battle number 1763. Alright, let's do a turns battle now. Yeah, we've actually not had one of those in a little while, so this is kind of due for one, you know. Ah, Batman. Very good. Very good choice, game. Who will be on this side? Oh, great. Not Shinze. That's a character I thought about getting rid of. That doesn't really do much for me. Oh yeah, this kind of odd version of Fox that I have that kind of has a questionable AI. And this is the original Huey. I don't even know why I have the original Huey Freeman still instead of just keeping Dark Luigi's, but I have both anyway, just for collection's sake. Wait a minute, there's another Batman in this one. I think that might be classic Batman. Alright, even the original Huey Freeman should be able to take this guy down, please. Yeah, and mostly, if I ever do create a single, roster that's more meant for just singles tournaments, I definitely gotta take some notes from Salty Bets, I think. Because, if you've ever seen them on Twitch, they actually, they showcase some really, really good one-on-one matches. I don't know how they do it, man, but boy, they just have a really, they know how to find characters that'll put on a really good show. Sadly, my roster is such a clusterfuck. It's just, oh man, I would have to pretty much almost, like, redo it from scratch to get it as good as that at this point, and I really don't want to do that. It's one of those things, it's like, this round, like, in a way, my roster might be kind of shitty, but you know what, hey, it's my shitty roster. You know what, I hold it near and dear to my heart. Man, Fox actually won. Way to go. Good luck doing anything with half your health, but hey, you got one win. Hey, if you can beat Myling, I'll give you credit, but you will not beat Possess Haida. I don't even care if the planet's a lion and you all of a sudden find a genie to grant you 3 wishes. Cause even if you did, there'd be no way you could even wish to beat Possess Haida. There's just no way. Yep, didn't even make it to him. Just as I thought. See, with Batman, this is. I'm actually very curious because I didn't think it would be two Batmans in here. No, it's just this Batman. Oh, I was hoping it was classic Batman. I think this is like. This is more or less like animated. No. I forgot which one is more like the animated series Batman. I know I have one of them. Man, but my lane blocking that like a champ.
I am vengeance. Down you go. Batarang. Gotta move. Batarang. Batarang. Down you go. Down you go. Batarang. Batarang. I am vengeance. Batarang. Batarang.
Down you go. Oh no. Batarang. Oh no, a beautiful counterground from my Ling. Gotta move. Batarang. There's a chance he might be able to pull this off. Batarang. Batarang. Down you go.
Gotta move. I am vengeance. Batarang. Batarang.
Man, this is like an all-out tactical dogfight right here. Yep, not anymore. Wow, Batman does take it though. See what he can do with about half of his health. Good luck against Possessed Haida. You'll need it. That's all I'm gonna say. You'll definitely need it. Oh, he's in Captain Falcon mode. Yeah, there's no. I'm sorry, Bats. You're not gonna do it against Possessed Haida. Just sorry. Yes. Yes. Sadly, though, Shin Zero is gonna win this one. Wow, I'm surprised that kid got him. Jeez, it's like he was like, wait, what? Base? What? What were you doing there? Please prove me wrong, Possessed Haida, because just every time I see this character, he usually wins. Yeah, never mind. I think he just won. Oh. Nope, no, not quite. But see how much freaking damage this character does? I mean, for God's sakes. Like, he's almost as bad as, like, Cat and Ann. I think he pretty much is on that level. I think the difference is that he can't, like, heal himself. Get ready to kick butt. I'm surprised he avoided that, jeez. He's too short for the Batarangs, Bats. What? Oh no, that was bad timing. I think if he was like right up next to him, I think he might have been able to tech his way out of that. Oh no, yeah, as I figured. So that's awesome, I'm like, yeah, it's over. That's my roster for ya. Well, you can predict matches just by one character appearing. Balance, people! At any rate, though. Alright, I'm gonna roll dice, so I'll be back. Okay. Well, for the lack of turns battle, seems like the dice really wants them now. Alright, at any rate, let's see. Random Google Battle number 17... Oh, dude, wow, I'm so bad. Random Moogabout number 1764. Blah. Jeez. Let's see. Let's go for another one. Here we go. Again, forgive me for stumbling. I'm just so tired. But yet I'm recording anyway. Cause I love doing this. Oh, this should be a decent first match. Mecha Zangief against Sodom. Alright, we actually got normal looking people. Oh, I say that, and I think we got freaking cheap Homer Simpson in this one. Yeah, Mech Zangief is. I think he's better in Simul mode because he's just not teching through any of those combos that Sodom's dishing out to him. Nope. Honestly, I wouldn't mind it if Sodom just won, because I'd rather him win this than freaking Chief Homer Simpson. Oh my god. I don't know why that happens. Like, it's not like we're even in Simul mode either. Like, that shouldn't be glitching at all. Like, it shouldn't be glitching, period. And you're done. Yeah, I honestly would not mind if Sodom just continued on his war path of craziness. Oh, I forgot about Leopoldin. Oh yeah, so that's who that was. This character is freaking bizarre and crazily powerful. I mean, like, wow. It's pretty much a dog taking control of the inside of a hippo mech thing. Oh my god, that Shadow Omega's hero! Okay, never mind. It's not even gonna make it it's not even gonna make it that far. Like, whoops. Oh god, this fight's gonna take a long time. Whoa, that does a lot of damage to him. Jesus! You see that? I didn't even notice that earlier, if he even did that. Wow! Took up like half his friggin' health! It's like, sweet god. That's it. Wow, he's done. And you'll be dead in about maybe like five to 8 seconds. And go. Okay, maybe we're like 10 to 20 seconds. And you're done. Alright, good. Alright, yeah, that turns battle really could have been a lot longer too, so I'm glad it wasn't as long as it could have been. But hey, that was a twist. Shadow Omega Zero. Yeah, I actually did not know that was Shadow Omega Zero at first. So that actually kind of took me by surprise. So you know what? It's good it at least threw me on a loop. It probably didn't throw a lot of you guys on a loop, but you know what? Yeah, that's fine. It is what it is. Alright, random movie battle number 1765. Alright, let's see. We got another one. Yeah, we do. Yeah, let's do yet another turns battle. Yeah, I got two fives. There, so. Wanda. And lastly. Oh, she's the cheap Yumu. However, in turns battle, she is not nearly as deadly as she is in a standard single or doubles match. Hi, Giga Bowser. So you got Cody, Tornado Man, one version of Kay and Wanda. On the other side, Giga Bowser, Ash, Tin Star, and Yumu. Yeah, Giga Bowser might win this all if he times his moves right. Come on, Cody. Please just tech through him. Just destroy him. Because Giga Bowser's like a freaking sponge. He just takes so many freaking hits. I don't even know that was right now, but you know what? That's okay, because Cody is about to win this thing right about now. Alright, now we're moving on to Ash. Oh no, God, no, Orochi Ash. That's right. I forgot I had this. Moreover, I think that's the first time I've seen Orochi Ash on just a regular battle. Yeah, because I tested Orochi Ash before. Yeah, never mind. I think Orochi Ash is going to win this. Yep. Cody, just keep Ash pinned against the wall and you got this. Oh, no. Yeah, good luck, Tornado Man. You're going to need it. Hell was that? Tornado Man, please. Please tell. No, you. Surely you can't be serious, Tornado. Wow. What the? Wow, really? Okay. They just both opened up with a hyper. That was actually kind of cool. I think I might use a thumbnail. I almost wish I was one of the heel clones. Man, no contest. Please be the early version of Wanda. Like, I really want to see. Oh, no, I don't think it is. It's the newer one. She seems kind of big. And, of course, you blocked that like a pro. Actually, no, maybe that is the older one. Man, wow. Why couldn't Orochi Ash be the last one? Because, I mean, Yumu isn't nearly as good in Tars battle, so she was kind of hindered a little bit. Orochi Ash is actually the most powerful character on that side, believe it or not. Alright, let's see. Alright. Alright, Ready Moogle Battle number 1766. Alright, let's go back to a 4 versus 4, which I think I'm already in the correct window. Yep, I think I am. Yep, I am. Good. Oh, jeez, now we got regular Bowser. Man, Giga Bowser and regular Bowser, all in the same episode. Gotta love that. Oh, my God, Roadrunner. I want to know who both of these guys are with. I am very curious. Alright, Bowser's with, looks like Respife. Looks like Respife, Jetta, Satuki, possibly, then you got Jace, Yumu. Now this actually is the cheap Yumu, so never mind. This battle's gonna suck ass now. It went from being possibly a really good match to being a really terrible one now. Yeah, I love it. Just cause one character. One character literally just has to ruin it for everybody. God, I think Bowser's dead. Oh no, that's Kong's Jetta because he's freaking flying around in the air like a wuss. Oh, Bowser actually did die. I don't know, man. There is maybe a chance that Yumu could lose this. Possibly. That is really highly unlikely, but we'll see. This battle might be more interesting. It might be more interesting than I'm giving it credit. Oh God! R- 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 Roadrunner? What is going on? I think it's called this attack is freaking so bad in Cyber Mode, it's freaking hilarious to watch. Wow, man. That completely ruined their chances. That along with Yumu going into her other form there. Oh man, that was bold. Yeah, Roadrunner kinda screwed things up there a little bit. Oh my god, this is so freaking mean. Like, what's it, like, three times you use that on? Like, I don't know if it's him using the attack over and over again, or if it's the attack just looping. My god, that was not even... What? I'm not gonna lie, that was actually kind of humorous. I mean, good god. I would have loved to have seen the other side lose, but you know what? Roadrunner kind of... He both kind of maybe... I don't know, I can't even say he no, he didn't ruin the fight. That was more Yumu. But hey, Roadrunner certainly made a lot more entertaining, I think. But at any rate, let's see. Alright, let's see. Random Booger Battle number 1677. No. Switch that. 1767. My god, I am... Oh. This is why I can't wait to get the marathons. There's not nearly as much memorization required. Okay. Alright. Cue record scratch sound effect here. If I was any good at editing, I would do that. Alright. Write a book about it ever. 1767. Alright, let's back it way off to a 1v1. Finally, we get a mano-a-mano match here. Let's see what we got. Alright. Oh man, why do I forget who the... we'll see later. Yeah, my mind is not in the right state to remember this crap right now. And we got Jeff. Oh yeah. Oni Iromura, alright. Yeah, this match is gonna be kind of lackluster, honestly. And I really need to remember to get rid of these, because... I thought originally that these versions of these Earthbound characters, like the ones that were taken from the game itself, like the sprites... I thought that these characters were a lot more beastly and spammy, but they're just... I don't know, they're really not that impressive. There you go. Aw, oh, come on, Oni. Put your back into it. Show that little kid who's boss, and... And while I question his ethics for, you know, literally beating the snot out of a kid, let's continue to watch this. Granted, though, Jeff is no ordinary kid, though. I mean, if you're familiar with Earthbound slash Mother 2, you'll know that he's a technical genius. And, pretty much an expert inventor slash even, like, demolition. You can also argue maybe, like, demolition's expert, too, because of that. You know what? That's a great quote. This is fun, but far too... Wow, that's actually a fantastic win quote. Like, that was, like, perfectly situational, man. That was cool. All right, so I rolled during the battle there, so let's see. All right, Random Booger Battle number 1678. Let's see. But why do I keep on saying 616? Star. Bad star. very, very bad star. All right. 1768. All right, you know the drill. Random book battle number 1768. Let's do another single battle. No, another 1v1 here for y'all. Why did I hit that? Yeah, I hit turns instead of that. I don't know why I thought I had to go This is why I should have done this on my days off, but you know what? No, I decided to watch a bunch of videos instead. and now I'm cursing it. And who, I don't even know who that... Oh, it's crazy. Raise against... Alright, this magic is going to be terrible. You want to know why? Because Raisin is literally nothing but projectiles. And what's one thing that Crazy Hand cannot do? Block said projectiles? Man, I don't know. I was kind of hoping that Frieza match would have continued. Now we'll never know who the other opponent would have been. I take full responsibility on that one. Yeah, that was definitely on me. It's kind of funny that we've also seen both Master and Crazy Hand in this episode. That's it. Man, there you go. Just like that. Done and done. Raisin, nice 2-0 win over Crazy Hand. Alright. And lastly, random book about number 1769. I got it right. Let's end it off with the same way we began, with a triples battle. And click. Alright. We got, I think that might be Adamus. Actually, that's either Adamus or Snow, one of the two. And we got Iron Tager, or just Tager for short. Who are they with? So he's with Cinalti's version of Tristan and Chen Mao, and along with Bertar and Kamachi. That's really, so we've seen Jace and Berger. Like, what's up with all the character similarities we've been seeing in this episode? It's kind of funny. And again, friggin' Raisin and come, and my god, that match literally only lasted a couple of seconds. What in the hell happened? That seems about right. I was too busy chatting up a goddamn storm to not even notice that. You know what? Allow me to quote Sully from Monsters, Inc. Scream Team, and something's not right. My god! I think that might have been a double flawless. I mean, pretty damn close to a double flawless. My god, that was over in the freaking blink of an eye. Jeez. Well, there you have it, guys. Well, that about does it for the 1760s. Hope you all enjoyed this. As I'm trying to get things underway for finally getting my podcast started and all that. And then also, I thought about finally doing gaming commentaries, much like I did with Stargazer Playtime Talks. I'm not going to call it that, though. I think I'd rather just call it just Stargazer's Gaming Commentaries again. Generic title, I know, but you know what? I'm not terribly good with titles, and there's really not a whole lot of other original titles you can really use for gaming stuff anymore, so... Yeah, that's kind of the downside, unless you're really, really tailor-made for, like, a certain niche end of it, but, that's neither here nor there. At any rate, thank you all for watching this, and that said, stay tuned for the 1770s coming up next week, and I'll see you guys later.